Welcome back to Breslov Campus. Insights on the Parsha of the week, Parshat Chukat. There's many, many topics in this Parsha. It's full, packed. The passing of Miriam, the passing of Aaron, the manna, the singing of the well. But one of the main things that sticks out is the para aduma, the red heifer. The red heifer is something which is difficult to accept, in that it makes pure the impure. That's what it's for. Someone who came in contact with a corpse in the time that we had a temple, a Beit HaMikdash. So in order for this person to be able to re-enter the temple and eat of the sacrifices, he has to be pure totally from any impure contact with a dead corpse, which requires the sprinkling of the ashes of the red heifer, the para aduma, on that person, and accounting and a waiting period of 7 days of the sprinkling and going to the mikveh and all types of things connected to that 7 day period. But the ashes of the red heifer, it was actually a red cow, that its ash, it was burnt, it was slaughtered, and then it was burnt, and from the ashes they mix it in with this water, or this holy water from the temple, and it's sprinkled on these people who are impure in the process of the 7 day waiting day procedure. So what it did is it made pure those who were impure, but also something very strange, it made impure those who are already pure. To explain, the Kohanim, the priests who were involved in preparing the mixture of the ashes of the red heifer, of the water, and anything involved in carrying and being a part of the usage of the ashes of the red heifer, they were made impure. Even though the impurity is a temporary one, it's only until nightfall, where they have to refrain from eating. If they're Kohanim, they're priests, obviously, then they have to refrain from eating holy sacrificial meat from the korbanot, from the sacrifices. And also they have to immerse in a mikveh and wait until nightfall. So here you see something very interesting. The para aduma makes those who are impure pure, and makes those who are pure impure. Reb Noson explains, this is the power of the tzaddik. The tzaddik is someone who has the power and the ability to make pure those who are very impure. The tzaddik, what's the idea of a tzaddik? Reb Noson explains, A tzaddik is someone who's trying to bring righteousness into every part of the world, every part of the globe, meaning the most lost cases of people so far, so impure, that their living attitude is like dead. Like the Gemara says, that the wicked people, b'chayehen keruim metim, the wicked people, while they're alive, they're considered dead. They're like the living, walking dead. That's what they are. So now the tzaddik has an ability to make pure these type of people who are so impure through his teachings, his revelation of godliness in the format that he brings it, bringing down the deepest levels of the Torah in a format that is accessible and can wake up people. This is the work of the tzaddikim. Like, if we want, as an example, what Rabbi Nachman said about himself. He said about himself, I did not come to this world for myself. I came solely for the purpose of bringing the Jewish people back to Hashem. So this is a hint to an indication, a lesson, a title to what is the mission of the tzaddikim, to bring back those who are farthest, to make pure those who are impure. But in the process, the tzaddik, by going down into such domains of impurity to connect to these lost Jewish souls, these lost sparks, these lost souls, this trapped goodness, to get into it, to their darkness, into the evil realm, and to open up the doors and to bring out, to release all those lost people, the tzaddik also has to experience a type of impurity, but it's a mild impurity. It's not so severe. Like in the actual red heifer, preparation, the parah aduma ashes, the kohanim, like we said, they were rendered impure just until nightfall, and they would have to go to the mikveh, and that's it. As opposed to someone who became impure with a dead corpse, he's really impure. He's not allowed to enter the Beit HaMikdash. He has to wait a 7-day period. Here, the kohanim, it's a light impurity. So too the tzaddikim, they also have a type of a light impurity, but it's removable. It's something they can wash off, and then they are themselves again. So this, Rav Noson explains, is the idea of the para aduma. The para aduma refers to these tzaddikim, who also, another connection, is they're willing to go down to the level of being ashes, of efer. In other words, they have such a strong power, these tzaddikim, they're able to bring themselves so down, so low, to save other people, that they reach the level of ashes, nothing. What's ashes? Burnt out. And in it is this level of holiness. It comes together with this mayim chayim, living water, water that comes from a mayan, from a source, a water source. And the water, as we know, is the source of life. Mayim chamim, the water is water of life. Also the Torah is called water. So these tzaddikim who make themselves into afar, ashes, to able to use the water and being sprinkled, in other words, reaching, penetrating the most lost cases, the people who are the most lost, and getting them to wake up. This is the idea of the tzaddikim. Rav Noson explains the idea of the red heifer, and again, how it makes pure those who are impure, and how it makes impure those who are pure. But to remember that it's only a temporary impurity, a very short, light impurity. And this is the power of the tzaddikim.